Alrighty, if you can take your feet so they're open, I'd like you to drop your head to one side and then move your head to the middle. And drop your head over the other way and move to the middle. And then breathe out. Dropping down and then rolling round to the front. And back the other way. Like down and round. And do it again. And then from here, if you can roll your shoulders, bring your shoulders up to your ears, squeeze the blades and press them down. Breathing in, breathing out. Just tuning your attention into your breath. Especially if you've had a busy day. And I'd like you to take your arms wide and rock your body weight forward to your toes and rock back to your heels. Forwards into your toes and back to the heels. So you're just feeling the ground underneath your feet, connecting with the floor, testing balance. And adding in, arm circle back as you tiptoe. Rock back into the heels. Experienced Cheltenham Ice Rink yesterday, the business networking group. That felt quite good fun on a Tuesday afternoon, no kids around. Okay, let's reverse, go back in the opposite direction. And spreading out the fingers, reaching into the fingers. And last one. And then come in, stand on the one leg. We're going to sweep the foot forwards and back, pointing the toes. And we get a little bit of height in that leg. Changing to the other side. Pointing the toes, and can we grow an inch taller by elongating, thinking about posture, lengthening up through the crown of the head. Taking our feet a little bit wider, softening the knees. Moving into a side lean, breathing in as we lift. Breathing out as we lean. And we're going to come down, sweep round, just hanging loose. And then going back the other way, dropping down and round. Keep going, just letting Rodney in. If we can do that just a couple more times, down and round, and back the other way, hanging loose, and coming down. We're just going to flop into the middle and just sort of shake your arms, your head, your shoulders a bit sort of ragdoll like, floppy and loose, just hanging loose there. And then if you can bring your feet in. Hi, Rodney. We're going to tiptoe balance with the palms facing up. And can you stay steady on your feet as you turn and look towards your back hand? Moving to the middle, and we're going to squat down. Brush the fingers against the ground, opening the arms. Turn, look behind. Move to the middle, and sweep down. And let's do it again. And look behind, move to the middle. Let's keep that going. Can you go a bit further as you look behind now? that one more time each way. Get ourselves moving, oil the joints. The last one, each side, final one, the other way. And you turn your toes outwards. Tuck your bottom under and draw your belly button muscle in as you move into a plie. We'll think about the posture of the knees angling out. And let's do that again. Think of opening into the hip. Keeping your posture elongated and upright as you come down. Breathing in and breathing out. We're going to bring our arms overhead. Pushing down through the heels as we lift. Opening, down, push into your heels. I'm going to stay down there a little bit longer now. 3, 2, 1. Good job. Let's do that again. Can we stay down? 3, 2, 1. And let's do it again. One more. Alrighty, keeping the feet turned out, but going just a little bit wider. Exploring the stretch, bending into one side. And coming back up. And as you bend, can you get that feeling of stretch through the inner thigh and push your bottom back? Breathe. Pushing the bottom back. Feeling the stretch. Just using this time as you're breathing and get moving, space of the day. Each side, pushing your body weight back slightly into your heels. Okay, good job. So, have a little drink. Okay, so let's come down onto our back. And we'll take a tuck and a tap. Tuck and tap. Breathing out as we tuck, in as we tap. And we do 4 more. The last couple, warming up the core. And then from here, we're going to bring one knee in as the other leg moves out. I want you to hug your knee. That knee may not have had a hug yet today. Loving thy body. Tucking in, extending the other leg. And point your toes as you extend your leg. Last couple. So final one. And then from here, we're going to roll onto our front and work on mobilizing our back muscles. So hands just slightly wider than the shoulder. Think about your shoulder posture and just weight your hip bones down. So let the hips sink into the ground. Press your shoulder posture down as you lift. We're going to squeeze our glutes on the lift to give our back support and then lower the body. Let's do that again. Pointing the toes as we squeeze the glutes. Lift, hold for 3, 2, 1 and come down. Let's do that again. If you've got a happy back, you might push on and come a little higher. Listen to your back. If it's a bit niggly and sore today, you might prefer to keep it down to an easier version. You choose. So just tuning in to what your back is telling you today. Tune up if you're going a little higher. Breathing in on the lift. breathing out on the lower. We do that three more times. The last couple. And final one. Alrighty, from here, I'm going to move into a plank. So if you can make a fist and come up onto your forearm. So we're now on the knees, tucking the tailbone under slightly so the core is active. Can we hover a single leg? Hold the plank position, pointing the toes. And then as we transition to the other side, we're going to imagine we've got a little tray of marbles on our lower back. So as we move from one leg to the other, the aim is not to lose the marbles. Level two, we're going to reach our opposite arm forwards and then back down. Can we keep the marbles steady as we reach? And then release. Breathing in and breathing out. Pressing the shoulders down. Let's do one more on each side. And then from there, we're going to take a sit back into child pose. So opening the knees, lengthening the arms, and allowing the forehead to rest down, breathing deeply. Applying pressure with the hands against the floor. I'm going to wriggle the fingers forward slightly, pressing our palms down, breathing deeply. So let's release from here. If we can meet up in the downward dog. And we're going to mobilize through our calves and our feet. So we're going to push down on one side as we flex the toes on the other, holding for a few seconds. And let's give that a go on the other side. Breathe. Pushing down with the heel. And switching to the other side. Try to keep your tailbone lifted. You kind of push your bottom up in the air, softening the shoulders. Last couple, flexing the toes to keep our toes nice and mobile. Just going to do that one more time. Now, can you touch your opposite elbow and knee together and then extend up? Let's give that a go on the other side. So knee and elbow together. And then reaching up. Breathe. Let's take a walk. Enough of that. And come down onto our backs. Puta Mahita. Okay. One of those days today where I'm like, I've got thick socks on, a few layers. I'm absolutely baking. Quite mild, isn't it, today? Alrighty, so from here, we're going to take our opposite arm and leg away as we move into our Pilates single leg stretch. So pointing the toes, reaching out, thumb to the floor. Level two, knees here at 90 degrees. Can we do it with a bit of imprint in the lower back? Our next level, straightening the leg, we're going to point the toes and then flex. So pointy toes and then flexy toes. We're going to do that four more times. Last couple. You finish your final one. Can you place your hands on your knees and do this? Circle around, closing your eyes and just massaging your lower back against the ground. Breathe. Just getting into the feel of massaging your lower back. Letting your back relax. And then reversing. Time, and then we're going to circle our knees like this, opening the knees, closing the knees, circling them in, out, and around. One more time, and then reversing. Allow your knees to kind of fall apart, give in to gravity, mobilize your hips, get good blood flow around the hips. Last couple. The final one. And then from here, can you rock up to seated? We're going to move into some yoga stretches. So if you can keep one foot forwards, opposite hand on the ground, and then we're going to turn with our top arm up, straightening out through our back leg. Breathing deeply, eye gaze up towards the ceiling. Allowing your hips to sink a little bit. Alrighty, and then from here, we're going to walk our hands, have a little look at the world from a different angle. So wide with your feet. Head drop down. Just rocking your body weight back to your heels and then forward into your toes. And you might explore your stretch a little bit further down. Just finding the sort of edge of your comfort zone with it. Breathe. And then from here, let's turn around so that we're facing the other way. So we've got the opposite hand on the floor, lengthening up with our top arm, allowing the hip to drop, reaching that back leg away, wriggling the toes back to allow the hips to come down. Breathe. Then from here, let's move into a wide leg position. So opening our feet, we're going to focus on pointing the toes and then flexing up. So if you can point, keep a lift in your chest. And then as you flex your feet, can you get hold of it or your shin or your ankle? This arm over and just kind of being with a bit of uncomfortableness as you lean. Inhaling and lifting, pointing the toes, lifting the chest, and lean. Again, just finding that point of a little bit of discomfort, holding for a few seconds where it feels a bit uncomfortable, and then coming back up, lifting the chest, and leading. And as you do it, I want you to notice if it feels like your calves are in connection with the floor, or is there a gap under here, under your knees? So work it over time, just gently getting that connection with the ground on both sides as you go into the lean. And over time, as you get more supple, you see with that consistent practice that makes all the difference, we're going to scoop the bottom arm away for next level. Breathing out as we lean. Breathing in as we lift. And we do one more each way. One last one over on the other side. If you can give your legs a bit of a shake out, we're going to crisscross through our legs. So I want you to pull your feet in. If it's tricky to cross your legs, you can always take your feet open wide, particularly if you've got trouble with your knees. So find what feels doable, and we're going to lengthen up, arms up, and then we're going to go quite wide with the hands as we drop the chin in. So chin down, wriggling the fingers forwards, breathing deeply. And sliding the hands back in. Inhaling, lifting, exhaling and leaning, wriggling the fingers forwards, breathing in as we slide in, nice long exhale as we come forwards and down, sliding our hands in, reaching up, and can we go that little bit further with each one. If you're doing a cross-legged version, this next one, I'd like you to bring your other leg over the top. So if you can switch them around, elongating the spine, breathing out. Breathing in as we come back in. Now, one of the things I found when it's tricky to cross the legs is that just gradually doing a little bit each day can really make a difference in being able to do it. If it's just a couple each day in a sort of gradual build up, that can make all the difference. Just going to do a couple more and that little bit further with each one. Certainly know for me, after a knee injury, after a fall on a bike, it was very uncomfortable. Just gradually encouraging my knee to do it over time helped it get back to it. Alrighty, from here we're going to have a drink. So if you have a break for some water, let's keep ourselves topped up. And if you can find some weights, so if you get some weights that will challenge you a little bit, you don't have any weights, you could always use a few saucepans or something like that. Okay, so we're gonna hold our weights like we would hold plates in our hand. You can draw your elbows back and squeeze your shoulder blades behind you. Feel the squeeze with your chest open, and then move your plates towards each other. Let's do that again. So squeezing the shoulders, 2, 3, and coming back in. Adding a rise on our tiptoes. We steady our ankles and then come back in and down. Breathing in, testing our balance. I want you to tune into your core. Allow your tailbone to hang. Draw your belly button muscle in. Feel for your center of gravity. Again, feeling for the center of gravity. Once you've got that, adding some reach with the arms. Steadying the ankles, feeling for the center of gravity. Next level, we add some lift up overhead. Or you can keep it just with the extension. With the weights that you're holding, try not to hang your weight down like this. We want to keep a strong hold in the wrist to build stamina and strength in the wrist. We're going to do 2 more. So final one. Resting off, rolling our shoulders. So keeping hold of our weights. And I'm gonna practice a little bit of balance, tiptoeing, walking, as we roll the shoulders. And then reversing, tiptoeing back. Opening our chest. And can we do that again? Tiptoeing forwards, shoulders coming up, squeezing the blades and pressing down. And tiptoeing back. So testing our balance. Interesting going ice skating yesterday with a group of just adults. So let me realise my balance is quite good, actually. It's quite a difference. Okay, have another drink. Then you find a stick and let's use our stick to monitor posture. Now, so knees together, heel towards our bottom, push your hip bones forwards, and then lengthen your lower back. So where you can feel your knuckles next to your lower back, can you elongate that lower part of your spine? Certainly know for me years ago that was really quite tricky, the stick. Well, the knuckles certainly didn't really touch the lower back. Took time to work on the positioning and the core. Let's give that a go on the other side. So be tuning in to your knuckles on your lower back as you bring your heel towards your bottom, squeezing the knees towards each other. You squeeze your buttock muscles to push your hip bones forwards. Notice how that intensifies the stretch. Breathe. You elongate your lower back against your knuckles, drawing the chin in, pushing the back of the head towards the stick. Breathe. Let's release the leg. We're going to stay with some stretch now. Moving into our yoga triangle pose. So feet wide, going to turn our toes out over here and then angle in at 45 over here. Now imagine your heels and your feet are against the wall. As you lean sideways, did your head sort of come off the wall? Imagine the back of your head is angling back towards the wall, because it's often the case that we'll compensate and lean the body forward, particularly when we're quite tight in the side of the body or around the groin muscles as well. We're kind of working in opposite sides of the body, sort of lower back and the side over here, and stretching down that opposite inner thigh. Eye gaze turning up now towards that top hand, breathing in. Now as you breathe out, can you lower your hand a little bit further down? Deep breath in, exhaling, going a little bit lower down, breathe. Alrighty, we're going to bend into the knee and bring our hands down either side of that foot and wriggle the back foot further away. Dropping the back knee to the floor, coming upright in the upper body. And if you can unhook your toes on this back foot, lengthening the arms out to the side. I'm going to drop the hip forward and bring the hands together in front of our body. Either stay with this version or add a bit of backwards lean. If your back feels happy with it, arms back by the ears, looking up to the ceiling, testing the balance. Bring the front big toe sandwiched to the floor. Relax your hips as you do it. Can you breathe into your belly? We're going to open the arms out to the side, rehook the toes at the back under, and push back up from the lunge. And then let's give our triangle pose a go on the other side. So I'm going to turn the toes out over here, angle in over here, and then lean off to the side. So again, imagine your feet are against the wall. As your head sort of come forward, imagine you can bring the back of your head to the wall. Eye gaze turning up towards your top hand. Deep breath. And as you exhale, lowering, deep breath in, and again as you exhale, going a little further down. And then from here, with our top hand coming down, wriggling our back foot away, allowing the hip to drop as we straighten the back leg out. Wriggling our back knee away, unhooking our toes, and lifting up through our chest. Arms out wide, kind of ta-da, hands out at the side, palms facing up. Breathe. Relax your hips down so they sort of sink and give in to gravity. Can we bring our hands together at the front? And can we bring our arms up and back by our ears? Eye gaze up to the ceiling to test our balance. Breathe into the belly. Again, deep breath. Alrighty, let's release. We're going to bring our hands down to the floor and move to our downward dog. So lifting the tailbone up, pressing our heels down. As you press your heels down, can you lift your bottom up? And pushing up to the ceiling. You just get the feeling like you're trying to arch your back as you press your heels down. Soften your shoulders, pressing your palms into the ground, spreading the fingers quite firmly. Alrighty, let's move into all fours. And we're going to let our chest lead the way down and back up. We're going to do some press work, thinking about alignment as we do it. So shoulder blades slid down the back. Breathing out as you lower, breathing in as you lift, keeping the chest open and the elbows squeezed in. Now you can either do it with your knees under your hips, level one, knees further back from your hips, level two, or third option on the toes. Breathing out as you come down and in as you lift. And we do three more. Breathe. Final one. Have a sit back, lengthen the arms, and rest the head on the ground. Deep breath. Alrighty, let's move to a kneeling position. So, kneeling, if you can take a sit on your feet. What we're going to do is a yoga-based quad stretch where we lean back. Now, if you've got trouble with your knees and your knees are not happy with this posture, I want you to come into a down-facing quad stretch. So you're here, you're either catching hold of your foot, or if you need a strap, you can hook a strap around or catch hold of a sock or a trouser. If you're doing the more advanced yoga stretch, we're going to lean back and lift the bottom up off the feet, straightening the arms as we squeeze the buttocks from behind, breathing deeply. Again, deep breath. Alrighty, let's release. And if you're doing one where you lie on your front, you can either repeat on the other side or give it a go with both legs. A more advanced version of the lean back is where we come down onto the elbows. You might be doing enough on your hands, so I'll let you be the judge of that. If you give it another go, either on your hands or your elbows is the more advanced option. Make sure you're doing what feels the right level for you. Deep breath. Let's release and come back up. We're going to find our downward dog again, hooking our toes under, pressing our heels down. And you lift up through your tailbone. So pushing your bottom up in the air, straightening your knees, pressing your knees back slightly. Breathe. Push your heels out slightly. Deep breath. Alrighty, from there, we're going to take a walk with our feet. And if you can come down onto your back, well done. Time for a bit of R&R. You can place your hands over your belly. I'd like you to open your teeth and think of your jaw relaxing. Allow your tongue to drop down inside of your mouth. The back of your head to sink into the mat as you relax down, visualizing any tension softening from around the little muscles of the eyes. You relax down. I'd like you to notice the space around your mouth, the space around your ears, the space around the crown of your head and your eyes. running your attention down around your throat, your neck, and your shoulders. Again, just taking a moment to sense the space around your throat and your neck and your shoulders. Moving your attention around the chest, armpits, and torso. As you relax down, noticing the space around the armpits, the chest, and the torso. Breathe. And as you sink into deeper relaxation, pay attention now to your belly, around your hips, your pelvis, lower back. Taking a moment to visualize the space around the vertebrae, the space in the hollow of the lower back and around the pelvis, the hips. Relax more deeply, moving your attention down around your thighs and knees. Visualizing the space around the back of the knees, around the thighs. Breathe. And bringing your attention down into your shin area, ankles, around your feet. Sensing the space around your shins, around your ankles, underneath the arches of your feet and around your toes. Feeling for the sense of space there. Just in the space around the whole of your body now. You rest in space. A moment to expand out from there, noticing the space of the room that you're in. Make a sense of space around that room. Sense of space beyond that. Expanding that sense of space out. Yourself some space. Bringing your attention to your breathing inside your belly. Taking a deeper breath in. Holding your breath for a moment. Exhaling out for a little bit longer. Breathing in. Pausing your breath. And exhaling out for a little bit longer. And let's do that again. Filling up. Pausing. And exhaling out. And just do that one more time, filling up, pausing, and exhaling out. And you're ready, I'd like you to open your eyes. And if you can roll to the side, we're going to regroup with a stretch. So if you can pop your legs out in front of you and let your head drop over to the side. I'm going to park our hand just here by the ear. A gentle pull down as we reach this hand away. Letting the head give in to gravity. Breathing deeply. Let's release. It's good to stretch the neck. And if we pop the hand just again by the ear, gentle pull, giving into gravity. Breathing into the stretch. And let's release and pop the hands just here at the back of the head, applying a little bit of pressure down with the fingertips. Breathing into the stretch. Let's release. So I hope that's made a difference to your day. If you'd like to.